Lecture, we have finished our module 3. So in this lecture we will be discussing the some numerical problem from your module 3 part 1, right? So here what type of problem we have to solve? So we have to generally solve the traffic and the probability of the cause. So here I am going to reading this numerical problem, and you have to solve this question in your way, right? So you just take a copy and pen and try to solve it. So I'll explain how to solve and you have to solve it. So the first question is, at a certain extent a total number of 500 calls are originated during the busy hour. If the average holding time of a call is 2.5 minutes, calculate the flow of traffic during this period, right? So here what we have given? We have given number of calls, that is your 5,000 call. And what is the time? That is a busy hour, that is one busy hour. So in this problem, we are getting 500 call in a hour, that means you see in the 60 minutes. So and other thing, what we have given the holding time. So what is the value of holding time? It is here 2.5 minutes, right? So now what you have to calculate? You have to calculate traffic, right? So what is the formula we have to apply here? So this is the formula. So this formula you have to apply. So what is this? This is equals to A is equals to CS divided by capital T. So here A is the traffic and C is the number of calls and H is the holding time. So and the capital T is the time in which C number of calls are occurring. So we can see that we are having all the three parameters to calculate the traffic value. So what is this? So C is equals to 5,000, H is equals to 2.5, and T is equals to 60 minutes. So apply this these parameter in this equation, you will get that value of traffic. So apply it. You just simply apply and put the value and just calculate it. It is simply multiplication and division. You need not the calculator, although you have to bring it, because in some problem you need camera, exponential term. So what is the answer? So I think some students are getting this. So the answer is 208.3e. Other student also solve this and get the answer and just tell me what is the answer. Okay, so 208.3. Okay, so I think you have solved this problem. Remaining student, please solve this and write the value of your answer in the chat box. Now coming to the second question. On an average, during the busy hour, a company makes 120 ongoing calls of average duration of 2 minutes. It received 200 incoming calls of average duration 2 minutes. Find the outgoing traffic, incoming traffic and total traffic. So here what we have to solve, we have to find the outgoing traffic, incoming traffic and total traffic, right? So here for outgoing traffic we have to consider the number of calls and the calls duration of outgoing call, right? So here we can see that how many outgoing calls are given. So here 120 outgoing calls for the duration of 2 minutes. So we have C, that is equals to 120. We have H, that is equals to 2 minutes, and we have T, because they have given that a busy hour, right? So it is 60 minutes. So simply apply these values into this formula and you'll get outgoing traffic. So just solve this. Solve this and write the answer in the checkbox. Also mention the point, that is you are solving point A, na? Okay, so the value you are getting 4E. Now coming to the next problem. So incoming traffic. So similar to this, we have to calculate the incoming traffic. So for the incoming traffic, we have to consider incoming calls and the call duration of incoming call, right? So here we can see that how many incoming calls. So 200 incoming calls, and the duration, that is your 3 minutes. So we have C, it is equals to 200. We have H, it is equals to 2 minutes, and we have T, that is 60 minutes. So apply it in this formula and we will get the incoming traffic. So just solve this. Okay, so student have given the answer, that is your 10E. Yes, 10E is the right answer. 10E. Now coming to the next part, that is total traffic. See, we have outgoing traffic, we have incoming traffic, and the total traffic is the addition of these two traffic. So what is this? So it is your outgoing traffic plus incoming traffic. So what is this? So it is 14E. So all of you just write 14E or whatever you are getting. Okay, so this is your second numerical problem. Now coming to the third one. During the busy hour, on average, a customer with a single telephone line makes 3 calls and receive 3 calls. The average call duration is 2 minutes. What is the probability that calls will find the line engaged? So you have to find the occupancy of the line, right? So here occupancy of the line is equals to also that one. So here you have to apply this. So what you will do, so you will have to calculate the total traffic, right? So here you have how many number of calls. So you have 3 incoming call, 3 outgoing call, and the duration of the call is 2 minutes. So the value of H is equal to 2, and the value of call, the number of calls will be 3 plus 3, that is 6. And what is the capital T? So it is given that in a busy hour, right? So it is 60 minutes, right? So you apply these values in this formula only, then you will get the answer. So just solve it. Okay, so 0.1E, right? So this is the right answer, right? So yes, 0.1, yes, 0.1, yes, 0.1. Now coming to the next problem. During the busy hour, 1,200 calls were offered to a group of trunks and 6 calls were lost. The average call duration was 3 minutes. Find the traffic offered. So here, how many calls are there? So traffic over means how many calls are allowed, right? So we have to consider here number of calls is equal to the total number of call, right? Then what is the duration? Call duration is equal to 3 minutes. And what is the capital T? So capital T is 1 hour, so it is 60 minutes. So for the traffic offered, it is equals to this call, and this is your time duration of the call and the 60. So just apply it into that previous formula, you will get the answer. So yes, the answer is, so what you are getting? So yes, it is your 60e, yeah, all of you are getting. So the value of traffic offered, it is equals to 60e. Now coming to the second point, that is your the traffic carried, right? So what is the value of traffic carried? So how many calls are lost? So six calls are lost, right? So here you have to find the total number of calls which successfully done. So how many calls successfully done? So you have, so here the call offered are 1200 and 6 calls are lost. So we will reduce the 6 calls from this call. So how many calls will be there? So 1200 minus 6 call, and you have to find the traffic for number of calls which is equals to 1200 minus 6, that is equals to 1194, right? So you apply this into that previous formula, you will get the answer. Yes, what is the value of traffic carried? Yes, so the value of traffic, it is. Yes, it is 59.7, and 59.7, all of you are getting. Now coming to the third one. So the third one is the traffic lost. So for the traffic lost, you have to consider the number of call lost. So how many call lost? So 6 calls are lost. So you have to find the traffic for 6 calls. So C is equal to 6, H is equal to 3, and capital T is equal to 1200. So you just put these value into the that formula, you'll get the answer. So yes, it is 0.3e. Yes, you also got 0.3e. Yes, you got 0.3e. So this is your traffic lost, right? So the fourth point is the grade of service. Now what is grade of service? The grade of service tells us the number of call lost or number the traffic lost. So the formula for the GOS, when we have given the traffic, so it is traffic lost divided by traffic carried. So we have already calculated traffic offered and traffic carried. So just divide these two, right, and you'll get the grade of service. So just do it and write the answer into the chat box. Yes, it is 0.005, right? So coming to the next problem, that is your fifth problem. Observation were made of number of busy lying in a group of junction at an interval of 5 minutes during the busy hour. The result obtained were this is. So what is your traffic carried? So you have given number of calls in a hour, right? So if the number of calls which is coming to in an office hour are given to you, so you simply apply the average to find the traffic, right? So it is just to solve this, averaging this the value of these 12 call, you will get the answer. So just find out the average of this call. Yes, how many you have got? Okay, 12e. Yes, 12e. Yes, okay. So up to here, we have solved the problem regarding our traffic unit, congestion, grade of science, traffic, right? So from this, that is your question number six to how many questions I have made from this topic. So we will see the problem related to your mathematical model. Right, so I'm reading this problem, that is your sixth one. So on average, one call arrives every 5 seconds during a period of 10 seconds. What is the probability that no call arrives, one call arrives, two call arrives, and more than two call arrives, right? So we have to find the probability of this, probability of call arrive. So how can we find the probability of arrive? So if you have remember, I have showed this formula. So here in this formula, we have finding the probability of call arrives. So here the x is showing the number of calls, and mu is showing the average call in that particular time, right? So here what is given, so we have given the time 10 seconds, so we have to find how many average calls are occurring or arriving at that 10 seconds. So here in this portion we have given that one call arrive every 5 seconds, right? So if one call arrive in 5 seconds, then how many call arrive in 10 seconds? So it is 2. So the value of mu will be 2. And the value of x will be asking in this question, right? So here what is this? No call arrives. So no call arrives means number of call that is equals to 0, x is equal to 0. So put the value of x is equal to 0, mu is equal to 2, we will get the answer, that is your no call arrives. So put it in that equation and write the answer in the chat box. Just solve it. E raised to power minus mu. Okay, so what is the value? Yes, 0.135. Yes, it is the right answer. So 0.15. Others, try to solve this question. Yes, 0.15. Okay, now calculate the value of one call arrives. So here what will be the change? So instead of x is equal to 0, there will be x is equal to 1. So solve this question, solve this numerical. What is this? So it is 0.27. Now coming to the third point, two call arrive. So here what will be the value of x? So the value of x will be 2. 2. So write it in this numerical and solve it. You'll get the answer. Yes, it is 0.27. Yes, 0.27. Yes, 0.27. Yes, 0.27. Now the fourth one. More than 2 calls. See, here we have solved. We have find the probability of 0, then 1, then 2, right? And in this portion, what we have asked. So here, and the question is asking that the probability that the call is more than 2. So what is not here? So here, 1 minus, see here, 0, 1, 2, right? So when we are solving the probability, we have already seen that if we are given the condition, and if we have to find that condition which is not probability of that condition which is not, which should not be there, so we will subtract it by 1, because total probability that the probability of all event is equals to 1. So if we will subtract all the probability, that is for no call and then 1 call and 2 call, will get the probability of 2 call arrival. So we have all the values, so just 1 minus and add these all probability and subtract it from 1. So what is the value of this? Just calculate it and write in the chat box. Yes, what is the value? Just write in the chat box. Okay, so the right value is, what is the right value? So the right value is, the correct answer is 0.325. Yes, you are making some mistake. Your value is not correct. See, you have to first add all the probability which you have already got in the first part, second part, third part. So what was the value? That is your 0.35, 0.25 and 0.25 that you have to add, and then you subtract from 1. So you'll get the answer. So it is equals to 0.35. Now you just try to solve numerical 7. So what is this? It is similar to yours. Numerical problem 6, you just try to solve it. Okay, so remaining question I will be completed into next section, right? So this is up to today's video, today's lecture. If you have any query, you can ask. I am giving you 5 minute or 10 minute, right? So no problem. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to leave this class.